I have a problem, and that problem is this. It's my 23-year-old gas boiler. It's non-condensing, it's not very efficient, and it's on its last legs, according to the guy who comes to service it every year. The heat exchanger's on its way out. And I don't really want to be spending £2,000 to £3,000 on a replacement boiler when I could be putting that money towards a heat pump. So I was looking around at what my first steps should be, and if you're a regular viewer of my channel, then you'll know I've got a Hildebrand Glow in-home display connected to my smart meter. While chatting with Hildebrand, they mentioned that they were running a trial using an environmental sensor combined with the energy data from the Glow display and a clever algorithm. All of this data is collected over a few weeks and it can be used to calculate the thermal performance of your home. I stuck the sensor on the wall in my hall next to my main thermostat and left it alone for 21 days. This was back in February while the heating was still in full use, which is important really because it's the performance of your heating in your home that you are baselining. The results were quite interesting. The HTC, or heat transfer coefficient, was 228 watts per Kelvin, and the HLP, or heat loss parameter, was 2.1 watts per meter squared per Kelvin. That's classed as average according to their scale, so there is room for improvement in my home for things like insulation and so on, but 2.1 is very close to the limit of being good. If I was a 2, then the house would be good. I have a pretty good idea of where my home could be improved. I know for a fact that the radiator in the kitchen is both undersized and the pipework to it is totally knackered for starters. And because I've got a water tank in the loft, there's a whole area of the ceiling underneath that which isn't insulated yet. This information is very useful, especially as it has now given me a baseline, and if I leave it in place, it can tell me my home's score as I make changes to hopefully improve things. But if I want to put a heat pump in and take advantage of government funding schemes, then what I really need is an EPC, or Energy Performance Certificate. So meet Neil, the EPC man for South Wales. Neil came and surveyed my home in line with the requirements for an EPC. Now, an EPC is quite an outdated way of providing an efficiency score for your home, but it's required if you want to sell or rent your home, and also needed for the £5,000 government grant on heat pumps. Neil measured all of the rooms, checked for standard things like the type and age of boiler, solar panels, average depth of loft insulation, house construction type, that sort of thing. A lot of it is points for ticking boxes, so you can bump your score up by using LED light bulbs, for example, but it doesn't account for things like battery storage yet. My house scored a B with 86 points out of 100. There were a few recommendations such as adding solid floor insulation, replacing the boiler and adding solar thermal hot water heating. Well, the second one I kind of want to do, but I don't want to put in a condensing boiler, that's for certain. Now that I have a baseline of my house before any changes have been made and I have the regulation EPC all issued, what's my next step? Well, Octopus Energy are rolling out their nationwide campaign to install as many heat pumps in the UK as possible. While I was at the Farnborough Fully Charged Live event in May, I put my name down for more information. I had a call back from them, paid the fully refundable deposit, and booked in for a home survey. So someone from Octopus Energy Services is turning up in a little bit, and they're going to do a whole home survey of our house. Now, I think that involves going into every single room and measuring it and doing like a heat loss calculation. Hopefully at the end of this process they'll tell me that they can proceed with doing an installation, so fingers crossed, and we'll see what happens.
I've even been out in the back garden and marked out a rough area where I think the heat pump would fit. Hopefully he agrees, but if he doesn't, there are alternative positions like along this wall here.
He's just left, and it took just under 2 hours for the survey, and nice guy. He gave me lots of useful information, took notes of absolutely everything, including my dodgy blocked radiator in the dining room. They're going to possibly spec their smallest heat pump, which is the 4 kilowatt one, and they're going to need to replace 7 radiators, some of them because they're really quite corroded, and most of them because they're just not big enough for the job. So I should get a report back from them in about up to 10 days, and I will need to apply for planning permission as well, so that's going to be a particular hurdle that I've got to investigate now. And that's where I will leave this video for now. I'll be back with another video once I get that report, and I'll go through the full details of what that contains with you. Don't forget to give this video a like if you found it useful or interesting, and please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on my heat pump adventure as it unfolds. Thank you to Neil the EPC man and Callum from Octopus Energy for agreeing to appear in the video, and thank you for watching, and to be continued.